name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate an experiment through which we find out whether or not calcium chloride has any impact on the boiling point of water. In a previous video, I demonstrated how calcium chloride may affect the melting point of ice or the freezing point of water. And I prepared two solutions, and I also prepared a slurry in which I just mixed water and ice. So you may reuse those experiments, or you may start your experiment anew with one beaker that contains approximately 50 grams of water, another beaker that contains approximately 50 grams of water, and 4.75 grams of calcium chloride, and another beaker that has approximately 50 grams of water and 9.5 grams of calcium chloride. I have all those beakers already made for my experiments that involved the freezing point depression. And now we're going to look at the boiling point elevation. For this experiment, we're going to need just a little bit of instrumentation. The first thing is a thermometer, because we will need to monitor any temperature changes that may occur. And then the second piece of equipment that we need is a hot plate. And that is right here. I will turn it on. And there are a couple ways in which we can melt ice faster. One way is to take our beakers and place them in a hot water bath, or another one is to simply take all of our beakers, place them on a hot plate, turn the temperature to a low medium to medium setting, and then simply wait until all our solutions boil. It has been some time since our solutions have been on top of the hot plate, and our water has been on top of the hot plate, and it appears that they are now boiling. And we can tell that they're boiling because small pockets of vapor are forming at the bottom and they are climbing to the top. So this is a good time to start recording the temperature. We're going to begin with the water, and we are going to submerge the bulb of the thermometer inside the water, trying not to touch the bottom of the beaker, which may record partially the temperature of the top of the hot plate. Be mindful that these beakers that have the boiling water and boiling calcium chloride solutions in them are very hot. So at this point, if you are not very careful with them, they may easily burn your fingers. You may use tongs to elevate them just slightly for the purposes of your temperature measurement, but as the top of your beakers is quite cool compared to the bottom of the beaker, you may be able to lift it up carefully. That also means, though, that the temperature of your beaker may slightly decrease temporarily, and then you're not recording the highest temperature possible. We can wait a little longer to confirm that the temperature is not climbing any higher. And in our case, it isn't. It stopped at 97.8 degrees Celsius. With that, we are going to wipe our thermometer. You have to be careful because the bulb is very hot. And then we move on to our solution with calcium chloride that contains the 4.75 grams of calcium chloride. And then we submerge our bulb, trying not to touch the bottom of the beaker, and we wait for the highest temperature possible. We shouldn't wait very long because the more of our water evaporates through boiling, the more concentrated our solution becomes, and then our original molality may be wrong. The temperature of my solution with the 4.75 grams of calcium chloride is 101.0 degrees Celsius. I will give it a couple of minutes and check again, but I don't want the boiling to go for too long because then too much of my water will be gone. The temperature remains steady at 101.0 degrees Celsius. We will do the same thing with the solution that contains the 9.5 grams of calcium chloride. We will record its boiling point, and then we will proceed with our calculations to determine how the addition of the different amounts of calcium chloride have impacted the boiling point of water. When our experiment is complete, we need to remain mindful of the fact that our beakers are extremely hot. Removal of our beakers should be done either by turning off the hot plate and then waiting until the beakers are cool enough to touch and removing them by hand, or if we choose to remove them as they are hot, we need to use tongs and place them either on a heat-resistant surface or some kind of other surface that will be able to resist the temperature of our current beakers.